Hi, this is Nash Shemar for InfoTaxCard.com. InfoTaxCard.com registers businesses, obtains licenses in all 50 states of USA, including DC and Puerto Rico. Here in this short video clip, I'm going to tell you how can you create a DBA, assumed name or a fictitious name with InfoTaxCard.com. The first step, if you want to know about DBA structure, you can use our knowledge center. Under knowledge center, you can see we have numbers of articles. You can read those articles to get more knowledge about DBA and to decide if the DBA or a pseudonym is the best structure for your business to start. If you are still not sure, then you can use one of your many options, like you have live support. You can click and follow the instructions, start chat. You will be instantly connected with one of our live representatives to help you for any of your questions. We have toll-free number, 866-754-4460, and our local number is 516-822-3100. And you can also email us any of your questions at support@infotaxsquare.com. Once you have decided that the DBA is the best structure for your business and you want to go ahead, let me go back to the landing page, and then you will read all these notes written in red to make sure you are fulfilling all the requirements, because some states do not allow you to register your business as a DBA if you are doing business as a sole proprietor. If you still have any question, you can use one of your many options as we have discussed earlier. The next, order now button. Order now button, you will create your account to place an order online. Write down your email address and the password, which you can easily remember. If you ever forget your password in future, you want to retrieve, you can use the client login area and follow the instruction. Forgot password tab, and you will receive your password instantly in your email. The second step is choose the state wherever you are planning to register your business as a DBA. County and the type of entity, what type of entity you have: sole proprietor, S corporation, C corporation, or any other entity. If you do not see your choice, please contact us either through live support, or you can also send us an email at support@infotaxsquare.com. Use our toll free number and our local number. Again, we have two type of DBAs. One is sole proprietor. If you are registering your business under your legal name, your first and last name. The second, if you are registering your DBA under the entity. Okay, let me choose the sole proprietor. If you are doing business under your legal name, your first and last name. Next, order information. Under order information, some states are required to run the publication after filing your DBA with the state or county. Like in California, if you do not run your publication after approving by the county, then the county has right to terminate your DBA. And so you have a cap of 30 days in California. So please make sure you are fulfilling all the requirements. If you still have any question about publication, you can either read these notes or can use one of your many options like support and telephone numbers. Do you need employee identification number? If you are doing business or registering your business as a sole proprietor, you only need employee identification number if you are going to hire employees. Otherwise, you are not required to have employer identification number. But for corporation, LLCs, and any other structure other than sole proprietor, you are required. If you want to include your order, you can click yes. Then sales tax, do you need sales tax ID number? Sales tax ID number is required if you are selling any taxing product or providing any taxable services. Then you are required to have the sales tax registration. To know more about, you can use help icon. Still, if you have any question, you can contact us. New subscription type, new subscription and renew existing subscription. New subscription, if it is a new business and you are going to apply it first time. Renew, in most states you are required to renew your DBA after a certain time, and the state will notify you if your DBA date is due now to renew. So I'm assuming that it's a new subscription. Under contact information, you will write your first name and your middle initial, if you have any, last name, address, suite, apartment number, city, state, zip or postal code, phone number, fax if you have any. A business overview, please write down here your detailed business description. Now DBA names which you are interested to register. We suggest you to please give us three names. If the first name is not available, we'll check with the second. The second not available, we'll check with the third. And if no one is available, we'll contact you for additional names or an alternative name. Write down here your address, city, state, zip code, zip or postal code where your business is physically located. Owner's information, please write down here the full name, social security number, date of birth is only required if you are conducting business in Utah or registering business in Utah. Residence address, city, state, zip code. Okay, after finishing this section, payment information, under payment information, please write your first name, middle initial if you have any, last name, billing address, city, state, phone number, card type, expiration date, card number, security code. And here the billing address is billing address information are very important. Please make sure you are using the address where you receive your credit card bill. Next, general comments. If you want to give us any special instructions to follow your order, so please write your instructions or comments. We'll follow or we'll contact you if you have any questions or reservation about your comments. Next, please read terms of the use agreement and disclaimer carefully. If you are agreed, you can check this box, then hit submit. It will bring you to the next page to review all the information, whatever you have typed, and if you're satisfied that you have included everything in your order, whatever you want to register you under DBA, then you hit the submit button or make changes. Will bring you back to the order on the online form, and you can make the changes if you need to make any. Then you will hit the submit button. After hitting the submit button, you will receive a confirmation number which we suggest you to please save it for the future reference. I hope this video clip was useful for you, and I thank you for watching it and choosing infotechsquire.com for your business needs.